When the Beatles Met Elvis, by Chris Hutchins with Peter Thompson, read by Chris Hutchins. I first met the Beatles in Hamburg as a reporter in November 1962. After Beatlemania broke out in Britain, I shared their adventures in the United States in 1964 and 1965. I had also been a dedicated Elvis fan since boyhood and had interviewed his manager, Colonel Tom Parker, on the telephone several times. I met him in Los Angeles in the summer of 1964, and the following year, I met Elvis at the studios of Paramount Pictures in Hollywood. My purpose all along had been to arrange a meeting between Elvis and the Beatles. I finally did this by introducing Colonel Parker to Brian Epstein and pointing out the advantages to both managers. However, a reluctant Elvis kept ducking the issue because the Beatles were now so clearly on top. But in September 1964, I did manage to arrange a telephone conversation between him and Paul McCartney. When Elvis finally agreed to meet the Beatles the following summer, I was the only journalist present at that historic event at Elvis's Bel Air home on the night of 27th of August 1965. This story, like all my others at the time, appeared in the New Musical Express. As I was travelling and living with the Beatles on their tours, all of my reports were aimed at maintaining the group's image in the eyes of their fans. It was only after I had left the NME and worked for 10 years as a press agent for Tom Jones, Engelbert Humperdinck, Gilbert O'Sullivan, and such bands as the Bee Gees, the Moody Blues, Eric Clapton's Cream, Procol Harum and Status Quo, that I could begin to write the real stories I had uncovered in the world of show business. I had many meetings with Elvis in Las Vegas in the 70s and came to know his wife Priscilla, who was by then separated from him and living in Los Angeles. On the night of 16th of August 1977, I heard from Memphis that Elvis was dead. I contacted Peter Thompson, who was editing the Daily Mirror that night, and the story caught the Mirror's first edition. Thompson cleared the entire front page and ran my inside account of Elvis's life, The King is Dead, across the center pages of the next edition. In 1993 and 1994, Thompson and I went to the United States to uncover the real stories behind the events I had witnessed 30 years earlier. Our thanks go to the many who helped us, particularly Colonel Parker, who guided us as we retraced Elvis's steps from his birthplace in Tupelo, Mississippi, to Memphis, New York, Hollywood, and Las Vegas, where the story begins, in the Imperial Suite of the Hilton Hotel in February 1973. It was quite a night.